Ladies and gentlemen, imekuwa a busy week na ukisema a month imekuwa a busy moment for President Ruto. Tulimwona last time alikuwa kule Mombasa akirai watu wa Mombasa wamruhusu afanye kazi na waziri ambaye amenominotiwa, Waziri Joho. After hapo akaenda kule Mount Kenya Runyenjes na ameopen up ama amezindua zile zinaitwa industrial park. Na wasewa huko wamefurahi sana. Lakini imekuwa a busy moment tu kwa Gen Z, wakirai watu watoke kwa 8-8, watoke wote na watoke mapema ili wasifungiwe. Alafu pilka pilka zangu za kusearch information ya vile 8-8 kutakuwa, nimeka macross Ndegwa Wajiro. Ndegwa Wajiro, kwa wale wanamjua, ni lawyer, amekuwa vocal sana akifaitia rights za Maina Jenga. Maina Jenga ni aliyekuwa mkubwa wa Mungiki. Watu wanamjua kama chairman. Ameambia watu ama amesema kesho ni siku kubwa sana, cause ndio watu watajiliberate from bad governance. Na akasema makarao wakikuja na guns au wanakuja na roses flower, wakikuja na violence au watakuja na simu na maji. Hapo hapo akasema kesho ni siku kubwa ya kuoneshana ama ya kusema ati watu ama raia iko na rights beyond, na ina say beyond kuvote. Akusahau kusema ati kesho pia ni siku ya kuoneshana kuna sauti imeshinda bullet, imeshinda water cannons. Akaendelea kusema watanyang'anya maskari silaha, watanyang'anya askari silaha kupitia kuwa na non-violence protest.
The right thing and to continue calling the country to order. So gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow is a big day for us. Is a day that we shall liberate ourselves from the tyranny of bad governance. Is a day when we shall make a statement that the people have the power beyond the vote. It's a day we shall make a statement that there is a power that cannot supersede the power of the bullet, the power of the water cannons, the power of the ammunition, and the power of the police. And we shall disarm the police by our action of non-violence. When they come with violence, we shall meet them with rose flowers. When they come with their guns, we shall meet them with a bottle of water. When they come with their guns, we shall meet them at their point of need with our iPhones and at least even some jugus for them to eat. One key strategy is that the government of the day must understand that we are non-violent. But that does not mean that we waive our right to self-defense. If they come with peace, we shall respond with peace. If they come with violence, we shall exercise our right to self-defense. They must understand about that. A right to self-defense is a constitutional right, is a legal right that is employed, or is a legal tool that is employed, or it's at the election or the person who is facing the aggression. So the point that the government of the day, because I know they are here listening, they must understand that we are non-violent. They must understand that our action of non-violence is not cowardice. They must understand that our action of violence must be met with equal measure. If they come with violence, I do not, he said that to the they are going to respect our rights to picket, our right to protest, and our right is the day to liberate ourselves as an individual, to liberate our children who have no voice, who are voiceless, to liberate the voice of our parents who are old and back at home, to liberate the voice of those individuals who are dying at Kenyatta National Hospital for lack of chemotherapy and radiotherapy, to liberate the voice of the children who are being born at Pumwani and they are going home without a BCG. So tomorrow is the day we are going to speak to the world that Kenya is sick, the country is ailing, and that it needs a physician. And the kind of the physician that we need to treat the ailment that we are suffering from is the physician who is going to give a prescription of good governance, a prescription of the rule of law, a prescription of the respect for human rights, a prescription for good governance and accountability. And we are telling William Ruto and his cabals that tomorrow we are coming to the city, big and small, huge and small, we are all coming to dramatize the world that Kenya is ailing and the needs of a physician. To the Westerners who are still supporting this Western puppet, we want you to hear us, that time for change has come, and we shall not relent until change comes and real change. And therefore we are saying freedom is here, freedom has come, and we must nurture freedom. So tomorrow we need to have those many, many songs of freedom, many songs of liberations, and tomorrow we need to have the song of get up, stand up. Stand up for your rights. Get up and stand up to emancipate ourselves from the slavery of bad governance. Rise up and stand up and emancipate ourselves from bad government that is not accountable to the people and responsive to the plight of the people. Wherever you go, be it in Nakuru, wherever you go, be it in Kirinyaga, be it in Nairobi, be it in Mombasa, the cry is the same. We want to be free. We want to be free. Viva, viva, viva. Thank you very much, Afrocentric.
Thank you, Ndegwa. Thank you. Viva, comrades. Viva. Kesho ndio ile siku, like we've said. Aya. Aha. I give the microphone to Nothing KE. Your hand is up. Tafadhali tunue mkono. We isn't the same.
Good evening, everyone. I salute those ones we have lost on the way, the wounded, and everyone else. I would also want to acknowledge Wakili Ndegwa. He's done an amazing job throughout, and the fact that he's able to articulate his issue without being contradicted, because he believes in the rule of law, which is what, as Kenyans, we are advocating for. Now, I wanted to highlight, you saw this gentleman, the British commander, General Walker, who came to Kenya to see our general, and he was saying, oh, you know, we collaborate along counterterrorism issue. That is a warning sign. These guys could attack us, could raise a militia to attack Kenya so that they come in and say, oh, you know, we are here to support you, and so you should stay woke, and we should make noise about that. We don't fight with Somalis, and they are all over in this country. And that is, they use Al-Shabaab when they want to destabilize Kenya. If you search, Al-Shabaab has never been recognized as a terror group because they are paid and used by the Westerners. It's the same trick they tried to use in Burkina Faso. So as we are agitating for our rights, it is important that we keep making noise that these guys have to vacate Africa. We don't want their bases here. If any of you imagine that there's anything good about the West, you need to interrogate what did they do in Iraq. Weapons of mass destruction were never found. And that's why spaces are very powerful, because we tell the truth. If you look at what they did in Libya, they just killed Gaddafi because, yes, Gaddafi used to punish people who opposed him, but he had done so well for his country. And even now they cannot allow his son to go back and rebuild his nation because they looted the wealth that was there. They got into Afghanistan because they wanted opium. Because apart from resources, drugs is another way they make money. And when finally Afghans liberated themselves, everybody is open to do business with them because they have very many rare resources. So you should not trust these people. A time has come as Africans, we are saying, we want to be free from entanglement of the West. We don't want anything from them. We want them out of our... which is basically a credit economy. We want to attach our currency wounds and boda-boda mostly to cause chaos. But I'm grateful for any mistake they are making, because when you turn a citizen against their own, if these people get wounded, they will come to the reality. By the way, these people threw me into a fire and they're not willing to spit on me to cool off. I hope the boda-boda guys will not follow through with the plans to disrupt peaceful protest. Another thing is, it's not all the police who are our enemies. We were trying to talk to some policemen, and you'll be surprised. There's so many voices who are supporting the movement, and some of them are saying even for them to get the jobs, they had to sell land to get into the forces. So they have a lot of dissatisfaction. They believe in it. They say they're exploited by their bosses. When we were not protesting, if it's the traffic police, their bosses will tell them, I need you to deliver this kind of money to me. Now the other, the ones who come for protest, again, they're put under a lot of pressure to attack. So they are also crying for help. So not all the police are on board with this particular government. Because for me, I can't believe that the Kenyan crime is because we are saying we don't want Western influence and we want good governance. I cannot believe that in this day and era, that is equal to a death sentence. But we are going to agitate, we are going to pray. I pray that the blood of Kenyans that has been spilled become a sword against every enemy of this nation, because we want to be free and freedom we shall.
Nikiendelea kutafuta more information pia, nikapatana na ujamaa akisema, Raila amekuwa akitumia maandamano kujinufaisha. Yeye akasema, ukiangalia demonstrations zimepita, huu jamaa ama Prime Minister Raila Amolo Odinga, kwa protest zote zimekuwa zikifanyika, lazima aingie kwa gava.
Yes, so I wanted to confirm that tomorrow is the day. You want to ensure that Ruto must go. Tomorrow is the day and Ruto must go. So I want to ask everybody to come out tomorrow. Because we want to remove this regime. This regime has nothing good for us. When you try to see, President William Ruto, when he came to government, he had only one target. That is to loot together with his friends. If you try to see what he is doing right now, is just collecting more taxes so that he can stay with his friends. He has nothing good. If you try to look at on the development of this country, he has nothing good to tell this country on the performance. Let's say things like road. If you try to compare, though Uhuru Kenyatta was also worst in the development of this country, but Ruto hasn't done anything at all. Uhuru was better because he had done something on, maybe if you could try to compare something maybe on infrastructure, roads, SGR, though he took some loan, we can see something. But Ruto is just looting, collecting more taxes, but nothing good for us. And tomorrow we need to confirm that Raila Odinga is nothing with, he has nothing to good on this country. Even a demonstration is not contributing anything. We need to confirm that it's us, that we are demanding our rights, that is, and it is not him. If you try Raila Odinga, just use the opportunity.
Go ahead.
Raila, if you try to look at the past demonstration, Raila just took advantage to get it into the government so that he can continue looting with President William Ruto. So we need to confirm tomorrow that we own this country. And we need to affirm them that this country belongs to us and we take back our country. We need to push hard, and I'm sure that everybody is going to join this movement. Even police officers who are harassing us on demonstration, I'm sure if we push hard and everybody come out, they are going also to join our movement. So we need to come home. We should not fear, because this country belongs to us. If we are to die, we are going to die. Everybody is going to die. Even William Ruto one day is going to die. So we need to all to come out, and we make sure that Ruto must go. So everybody should come out tomorrow. We need to come out, and we need to educate even our parents. Not only youths are going to be on the demonstration. Even our parents, we need to tell them that we want a good nation, and they should all come and join us so that we make sure that this person go out. Because their target only is to loot.
Wind up.
Okay. So what I want to tell us is we come as one and we push so hard, and everybody should join this movement so that we have a better country. Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you, Kibe. KOT Duke, are you there? KOT Don, sorry, Don Chapo, are you there?
Yeah, I'm there, man.
Go ahead, you are 3 minutes now.
Sir, this second time when I'm appearing on this speaker section, I'm here to condemn the bad things and also to add fire on tomorrow's plans. Nani alikuwa na submission ingine moto sana bana. That man called Mwaura, he's not in Kenya ko majuu, but submission yake imekuwa moto sana. Amekuwa na inject sana. Tomorrow we are prepared. Tomorrow tunatoka mapema sana. Mapema ni asubuhi bana 6 amka tokea wewe panda gari bana. Tao chwani kwanza hiyo masaa. Fika tao tulia hapo. Mambo yenda kwa vipi? Sieti tungoje kwa saa 8 huko tuone mambo imeshika ndio tutoke. Njia zitakuwa zimefungwa. Alafu bado kesho ukiamka bila hasira bana, piga ukuta ngumi, kasirika. Toka kwa nyumba one time. Kesho watu wamekasirika vibaya sana wazee. Wewe kwambia kesho sijui itakuwaje. Kesho ni ile 2 day bana. Kwanza mimi lazima nipande na bendera yangu kwanza hapo hivyo. Niweke bendera yangu personal. Eh? Kesho ni ile day. Tunakuja kurudisha Kenya mali inafaa kuwa bana. We are fixing the country tomorrow. So make sure you get out there. If you know you are a goon, you have been hired, those government bloggers, fuck you. Tomorrow we are there to liberate and to fix things, man. We don't want to live in this country like this. Thank you so much, Afrocentric.
Thank you, Don. Thank you. Next, Ashuja. Your hand is up. Shuja, unanisikia? Yeah, we can hear you. Safi sana, your time starts now.
Thank you. Allow me to greet you all in the name of our good Republic Kenya. Hamjambo. I'm really loving the psych, the energy and the anger in the air. Now, allow me to say just two things, two or three things within my 3 minutes. Number one, we cannot reiterate enough that our procession tomorrow, all our activity should be confined in... All our activity should be confined within the tenets of our constitution. We should be endeavor to be very peaceful, but yet very vigilant from all threats that might come over from, let's say, from the police and also from within. We should always keep the peace and maintain the peace. Number two, all this has really portrayed who Raila and ODM is. I'm a member of ODM, and I was very, very, very pleased to be a member. But after what happened, I'm now also a partyless. And due to that cause, Raila has come out to be a safe haven for Ruto, which makes him part of the mess that we are in today. So from now going forward, in the same basket that we shall be treating Ruto with, Raila also ought to be in the same basket. I'm really disappointed, and actually I'm very, very mad about what he did as a person and as a Kenyan. Number three, we as a people, we as a generation, we have to pay the ultimate price for us to be able to emancipate ourselves and to be able to live a life free of shackles of poverty, shackles of impunity, shackles of nepotism that has derailed development in our Kenya. The thing that nobody can attain or can be appointed on merit is something that is killing our youth and killing our motivation as a people. So for the sake of people getting jobs and opportunities on merit is one reason that we must come out tomorrow and fight this government. Now, let me address the reason why we are coming out. We are coming out to fight bad governance, to fight impunity, and to fight elevated egotism in our president. When is this happening? This is happening tomorrow, and the arena is CBD, and the supper is going to be served in the State House.